Welcome to the final stage, part 3, of converting a RedOctane PS2 guitar to be used as my universal gaming axe. To start, take a look at these photos. They are of my fretboard. Please compare these with yours to find where the ground contact is. The trace line to look for is the one that connects all the other fret buttons together as the common ground. I use the white wire that is twisted with the green wire from the Ethernet cable for mine. When soldering, just remember ground to ground, and the remaining 5 wires can be soldered to any of the digital pins on the Pi Pico. The video shows me soldering the green wire to ground. Ignore this as I corrected it later after testing. Not having the ground in the right spot will cause none of the frets to respond. Then I finish by soldering the rest of the wires to the digital pins surrounding the ground pin on the Pi Pico. Next, I reinstall the start and select buttons back into the guitar. They only fit one way. Then I screw the circuit board back to the guitar. Then I attach the Pi Pico to the mounting spot I chose before. In part 2, I mentioned the whammy bar's data and ground pins being incorrectly placed. This is fixed here by removing the data wire from the digital pin and connecting it instead to the analog pin of the Pi Pico. Also, in part 2, the superglue was not the best choice to use to hold a circuit board in place. There are 2 reasons. 1, if you ever want to remove it, you will destroy the board. And 2, because superglue will eventually deteriorate the PCB. Next up, and just for fun, I found my digital tilt sensor off the same guitar as the silent strum I had earlier. So I mounted it to the front of the guitar like it was originally and soldered the 2 wires. The following pinout is the last and corrected pinout for this to work for you, so check it out for the final details. Now that we are done with the hardware mods, we can focus on setting it up how we want using Santroller. The developer constantly updates this software with better features and is on Discord, ready to provide anyone with help. I will include the links below. Also, I should mention that I am not affiliated with the developer of this software in any way other than being a sponsor on GitHub, which I cannot recommend enough. Keeping this person funded will only allow an increase in productivity for this free software. In turn, it is not effective for me to go over all the instructions for using this software because, for one, it is constantly evolving, so it would outdate my video quickly. And two, I am not an expert. I have only been working with the software for as long as I have been making this video. I will include in the description below links to learn as much as you can about this. I start by configuring my Raspberry Pi Pico by selecting it from the list. This installs custom firmware that allows for assigning controller functions to the pins of the Pico. I chose the type based on what I plan to use it for. In my case, Clone Hero, so choosing Rock Band or Guitar Hero Guitar will suffice. I chose the latter. I disabled the slider bar and enabled the tilt option. Then, I move on to defining the pins that I want to use for frets. It is straightforward: press Find Pin, then press the button on the controller you'd like to assign to that action. For the green fret, I'll press the green fret button on the guitar. You do this all the way through. For my guitar, once I got past strum down, I have to remove the D-pad and PlayStation button configurations. I do not have these buttons on this guitar, and the program will not let you save it if you have invalid or unconfigured buttons. Onto the whammy bar. It'll ask you to push in the bar to recognize its connected analog pin. Then you can calibrate it to account for the high, low, and dead zones of it. Just follow the simple steps. The last thing I configure is my tilt. I use a digital tilt, so I change the option to reflect that. Then select Find Pin and tilt the guitar up. Click on Save, and it writes the new custom firmware to the device. Once it hits 100%, I'll close out of Santroller and run Clone Hero for testing. Because this video is on YouTube, I must remove the audio from the song. For the length of the song, you all can just bang your heads with me while I jam out quietly. Besides me sucking at playing, this mod is working great. Now, with this guide, anyone can take a broken, cheap guitar and reconfigure it to be their universal gaming axe. Thank you, everyone, for watching, and hit subscribe if you like what I'm doing here. Who knows what will happen next?